How to find hybridization in organic molecules? So any atom, normally carbon atom is involved, or any atom you can say, if it is surrounded by four electron pairs. This electron pairs include bond pair of electrons and lone pair of electrons. Pi electron pair is not included. If it is surrounded by four electron pairs, it is sp3 hybridized. If it is surrounded by 3 electron pairs, it is sp2 hybridized. And if it is surrounded by 2 electron pairs, it is sp hybridized. This is one basis, or you can say a singly bonded atom is sp3 hybridized. Look at one simplest case, ethane. In ethane, this carbon is surrounded by 1, 2, 3, 4 electron pairs. Or you can say it is singly bonded, therefore this carbon is sp3 hybridized. Alright, look at this carbon. This is surrounded by 1, 2, 3, 4 electron pairs. It is sp3 hybridized. Or if we have ethene, in ethene, see, this carbon atom is surrounded by 1, 2, 3 electron pairs. This pi electron pair is not included. So it is sp2. This carbon atom is again surrounded by 3 electron pairs, sp2, hybridized. Now look at this case, CH3CONH2. Alright. Look at this carbon atom. It is singly bonded or surrounded by 4 electron pairs. It is sp3. This carbon is surrounded by 1, 2 and 3 electron pairs. Again in a double bond, one bond is sigma and one bond is pi. So that pi electron pair is not included. Or you can also say this carbon is doubly bonded, therefore it is sp2 hybridized. This nitrogen is surrounded by 1, 2, 3 and 4 electron pairs, it is sp3 hybridized. So in organic molecules, there are more than one central atoms and all of them undergo hybridization. Alright. Now, in organic reaction intermediates, like normally carbocations are there, like methyl carbocation. Again, it is surrounded by 1, 2, 3 electron pairs. The type of hybridization is sp2. Alright, if it is a cyclic species like this one, this is positively charged. So, you must remember that in cyclic compounds, normally we do not write hydrogen. But you should be careful that valency should be satisfied. So, all the carbon atoms are bonded like this to hydrogen. But in this case, we have a positive charge. That means we have only one hydrogen. One hydrogen is removed already. Now, this is surrounded by 3 electron pairs. Therefore, the type of hybridization is sp2. Alright. So, in this way, you can find out the type of hybridization. Or if we have carbon anion. Alright. This is 1, 2, 3 and 4 electron pairs, sp3. Or we have, say, suppose this case. Alright, look at this carbon. This is surrounded by 1 electron pair, 2 electron pair and 3 electron pair. This one is not included because it is pi. So 1, 2, 3 means it is sp2. Or we have this kind of case. Okay. This is surrounded by 1 and 2 electron pair. These are the two pi bonds. So 1, 2. It is sp hybridized. So this is how you find out the type of hybridization in organic species. Now, if you have a free radical, in free radicals, we do not include the extra electron. Alright, so it is surrounded by 1, 2, 3 electron pairs, it is sp2 hybridized, like that. So you can find out hybridization on this basis, okay. Then we have how to write the shapes of, how to write the structures of molecules. Like you must remember that the valency of hydrogen is 1, means hydrogen is given single bond, oxygen is given double bond, and halogens are given single bonds. If halogen is central atom, then you can give 7 bonds to halogen, till 7 bonds. Not 7, all the time 7, till 7 bonds. Otherwise, normally this is sufficient. So if you want to draw the structure of a molecule, like say, suppose we have some molecules, like we have, say, we want to draw the structure of SF6. Just find out the oxidation state, plus 6, all right. And plus 6, and then this is the highest possible oxidation state, so we do not have LPs. Now sulfur is bonded to 6 fluorine, so it is sp3d2 hybridized, and if it is sp3d2 hybridized, that means it must be octahedral or square bipyramidal. So see, this is 1 bond, 2 bond, 3 bond, and 4 bond. So this is square planar, all right, this is square planar shape. And now this is square bipyramidal or octahedral, like that. Now if it is we want to write the structure of SO42 negative, again oxidation state plus 6, all right, then this is the highest possible oxidation state. We do not have LPs. Sulfur is bonded to 4 oxygen, so the type of hybridization is sp3. And if it is sp3, it should be tetrahedral, right? Sulfur at central, and now tetrahedrally 4 oxygen, 1 2 3 4. Now out of these 4 oxygen, 2 oxygen are having negative charge, so any 2 oxygen can be given negative charge. And if it is O negative, give single bond, and if it is oxygen, give double bond. All right, oxygen is given double bond, O negative is given single bond, so this is tetrahedral shape. And if we have lone pair of electron, it is very simple. Again, ammonia, this is -3 is the oxidation state, negative sign, forget about it. 3, then 4, then 5, 1 LP is present. Nitrogen is bonded to 3 hydrogen, plus 1 LP is also present in hybrid orbital, 3 plus 1 4, sp3. So similarly, draw nitrogen at the center and 4 corners tetrahedrally. One corner is occupied by LP and other 3 corners are occupied by hydrogen. That is it. So the shape is not tetrahedral, it becomes pyramidal shape. All right. So on this basis you can find out the shapes of molecule. Look at other cases, like if we have XCOF4, oxidation state is plus 6, then 7 8 1 LP, 4 plus 1 5 plus 1 6, type of hybridization is sp3 d2. All right, so xenon is made at central. All right, now we have sp3 d2, so it must be square bipyramidal, but we have 1 LP. All right, so it should be square. This is square planar shape, and 1 LP is present and 1 oxygen is present. So this is the structure. It is square pyramidal. It is not square bipyramidal. It becomes square pyramidal. In trigonal bipyramidal shape, and if LPs are present, you should be careful. LPs occupy, see, there are 2 bond angles. These bond angles are 120. And above and below, these bond angles are 90. All right, so LP causes more repulsion. So normally LP goes to any of the these 3 positions. Like if we have say, suppose we have IF3 plus 3 4 5 6 7, 2 LPs, 3 plus 2 5, sp3 D. Now we have 2 LPs, so these 2 LPs will go to 120 angle. All right, and iodine is at center, and this is one fluorine, this is second fluorine, and this is third fluorine. So it is T-shaped. What is the shape? T-shaped. All right. So on this way we can write the type of hybridization and the shape. SF4 plus 4, 5, 6, 1 LP, 4 plus 1, 5, SP3D again. And if it is SP3D, sulfur is at central atom, this 120 angle is occupied by LP, and then this is fluorine, fluorine, and this is fluorine. This is called seesaw shape. This is called seesaw shape. Alright. So this is how you write the structure of covalent molecules and covalent ions. Alright. In the next section, we will be discussing how to find out dipole moment, shortcut method. Alright. So let us discuss that in the next lecture.